Hey everyone, it's Kristen from k.becca, and for today's acrylic pour painting, I'm going to be using Floetrol as my pouring medium for the first time. Up until now, I've only used my DIY mixture of glue and water, which I think has been working out pretty well. But I've been wanting to try some other pouring mediums, and Floetrol is one of the more popular ones. It's a latex-based paint additive that helps latex and acrylic to flow and level better. I'm using the Floetrol at about a 1-to-1 ratio with the acrylic craft paint that I'm using for this painting, which I'll be pouring on an 8-to-10-inch canvas panel. So for the blue paints, I have about a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half of the paint to about the same amount of Floetrol, and I'm mixing the two until they're completely combined and I don't see any streakiness in the cup. For the white paint, I'm using about double the amount of both paint and Floetrol that I'm using for the shades of blue. If your paint is on the thicker side, you may have to add a little bit more Floetrol or even a little bit of water to get the consistency that you need for a good pour. I'll list all of the supplies and craft paint colors that I'm using for this painting in the description area below the video. If you want to see an in-depth, step-by-step walkthrough of my setup and supplies, you can check out the video at the link that should be popping up right about now. Okay, now that I've got all of my paints mixed with the Floetrol, I'm going to add some silicone oil to each color. I'm adding approximately 20 drops, or about an eighth of a teaspoon, to each of the colors, and about double that to the white. I'm not going to mix the silicone oil in super well. I'm giving it about 8 to 10 stirs after I add it. And I hope you can see here that you can still see the silicone oil a little bit in the paint. It's swirled in there, but still separated from the paint. I'll be doing a dirty pour with the flip cup technique, so I'll get a clean cup and start adding the different paints. Up until now, I would choose one of the colors and add the rest of the paints to the cup with that color, but this time I'm getting a clean cup and adding layers of each of the paint colors so I can build up several layers before pouring to see how that affects the result. When I'm done layering the paints, I'll flip the cup onto the canvas, leave it there for about 10 to 15 seconds or so until the paint has a chance to run out of the cup and onto the canvas, and then I'll lift the cup and start tilting the canvas to get the paint moving. I always keep some of all of the paint colors back, especially white, so I can add them manually later on if I need to. I've got some blank areas around the main paint pour, so I'll come in with some white to create a little bit of negative space around the colors. I really like the area at the bottom right of the canvas, and to a lesser extent on the left side there, where larger areas of the blues are coming through, and I hoped that would happen over more of the painting, so I kept tilting the canvas to see if the colors would start to separate more in that center area, and some more of the blues would come through, but that didn't happen. I do really like the texture that all of the little silicone cells made throughout this painting, though. I had enough paint left over for a second pour, so I'll go through the same process of layering the paint in a clean cup and using the dirty pour flip cup technique on the canvas panel. I'll add some of the white paint around the main pour area to create a little bit of negative space, just like I did for the first painting, and then I'll continue tilting the panel around until I'm happy with what I've got. I did add some additional white paint and the leftover from the flip cup in the lower right corner since there was a blank area there. There's definitely a lot of playing it by ear with paint pouring. You just add paint where it's needed or where you want to see it as you go. This painting is my favorite of the two. I like that there are larger areas of the shades of blue to contrast with all of the white that's going on, and I also really like the sharp cutoff between the color and the white along the top left side. The negative space of solid white helps set off the colored areas even more. Here's a look at both paintings after they dried completely. I'd say the biggest difference that I noticed with using Floetrol instead of the glue and water mixture for my pouring medium was that I didn't have to deal with any bubbles in the paint. With the glue and water pouring medium, I often have lots of bubbles in the paint before I pour and spray the paint with isopropyl rubbing alcohol to pop the bubbles. For the Floetrol, I didn't need to do that. You can find a full list of supplies used for these paintings in the description area below or in the area below the video if you're watching on k.becca.com. If you like this video and would like to see more acrylic pouring videos, it would be great if you give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll tune in again soon.